Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to your beautiful, fabulous Friday, November 25th, 2022, the day after Thanksgiving. Still hope your day was wonderful. Yes, you had a wonderful day with your family and loved ones. But in your part two of episode 912, we're going to learn about enduring hope. From Zachel Dixon, derived from Revelation 21, 1 through 8. So if you're excited about this, we'll smash the like button. And remember, smashing the like button will help the video reach other people. And I would like to have at least 4 likes on all my videos. Go back to watch the beginning of the morning episodes this morning I explain the procedure for that. But until that gets met, it's 4 likes only for every video. Until a certain number of videos are compiled and all have 4 likes. And then But subscribe if you birthdays, anniversaries, and prayer request in the comment section below. And how do you endure? What's your definition of enduring hope? Let me know. Subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends, and help me reach that 30 subscriber mark by January 1st, 2022, which is about 4.5 weeks away. And if we hit that 30 mark before January 1st, then we will go to 50, and you'll have until Valentine's Day. If we hit it. If we don't hit the 30, we're going to just keep shooting for 30. And then we go to 50 when we hit 30. So, and then I'll figure out if it's after the 1st. If we don't hit the 30 till after the 1st, then you have to forgive me. I just come back from having to use the restroom, and I was having to. I was making a sewage deposit. If anybody catches what I'm trying to say, but I'm not trying to out say what I just did, but I was making a deposit to the sewage. I was making a sewage. A stinky deposit. But I got through with this morning's video right at about the end. My stomach started turning and everything. So I held it long enough to get the first video done. And I shut everything, well, put everything down in sleep mode, got up and went. So when you gotta go, you gotta go. So But if you, and I like to be at 100 subscribers by my birthday, April the 18th. So if you do that for me, I will greatly appreciate you. So let's learn about enduring hope from Zachel Dixon. She writes, doctors diagnosed 4-year-old Solomon with Duchenne muscular dystrophy. I've heard of that one. That's one of those rare cases of muscular dystrophy from the MDA. It's a progressive muscle degenerating disease. And a year later, doctors discussed wheelchairs with the family, but Solomon protested that he didn't want to have to use one. Family and friends prayed for him, raised funds for a professionally trained service dog to help keep him out of that wheelchair for as long as possible. So Tales for Life, which is an organization that trained my service dog, Callie, Zachel's dog, the person writing this, is currently preparing waffles to serve Solomon. Some of these names of these animals. Who? Why can't they have a simple name like Bob or... They always gotta have these crazy names. But waffles. I wouldn't name an animal that. picked up a dog that somebody threw out of the car one year. Back years ago. It was the only dog I ever, well, somewhat the only dog I had ever kept care of. Somebody, I was up at my aunt's house in Macon. At the time, she was living in this part of Macon, Georgia, and we went to visit her one Saturday. And I was outside doing. I don't remember. I was out on the sidewalk. There was a sidewalk, and there was a good-sized neighborhood. I was out on the sidewalk, walking around the cars, or just standing against the car, doing something. And I seen this car pull down past my aunt's house, just stop. And all of a sudden, I'm just looking at this car like, what'd he stop for? Next thing I know, I hear the door slam. Or I hear the door open. Like somebody's going to get out and... But I hear the door open. And then I'm looking down at the car, and I see this down on the foot of the... Below the car, as you can see up underneath the car, I saw this something come out of the car and down and got like thrown down on the ground. And I was like, and then the door shut, the vehicle pulled away. So I walked down to where that car stopped at, was looking around, trying to figure out what came out of that car. And I said, maybe it's underneath the car. And I got looking down there, and there was a dog. It was a Pekingese. She was, I don't know whether she was, had to have it taken out, or she was born without it, but she had one eye. And I don't remember which one it was. I think it was the right eye gone. If not, she had one eye. And she was cowered under that vehicle, scared. So I reached out and pulled her out and said, come here. Come here. Like trying to get the dog to me just to come and console her. Like I always do. And then before I knew it, I got her out, was consoling her, and it just basically bonded with her, and I took her down back to my aunt's house and had somebody go in to get my mom. She come out and says, can we take her home with us? Somebody just threw her out of the car. And then we brought her home. She stayed with us for a few years. We were. We were there in East Dublin. So, we were living in the trailer, one of the trailers in the trailer park we were living in, and basically the one we were living in before we moved to Georgia, or before we went to North Georgia, excuse me, but just one day, she crawled up under the house. At night, and then we got up the next day. We didn't know where she got off to. Well, somehow noticed she climbed up the house, and she died. Cause I found her, and I touched her. She was stiff as a board. I don't know whether she froze, or whether she just passed. So I had to grabbed a garbage bag. We set her in the bag, and then we went out into the woods. And then we went and dug a big, good sized hole. We made sure we can get a good sized hole. And then we set her down in the bag. We set her down in the hole, covered her up, and said a word over her. Still, I still miss that dog, but hey. But we also, when we lived here in Leesburg, before we went to Georgia in 95, the house we lived in before we moved to Georgia, and it was over on another street here, we had a cat, golden tabby color cat. One day, somehow or another, the back door was open. Well, she just wandered, this female cat just wandered right in the house. And then we adopted her right there. She had a litter of kittens. We gave the kittens away. And then when we moved to North Georgia, she came with us when we moved to Georgia. And then she stayed with us for years. Then we moved to North Georgia. She went with us. Well, we lived in an apartment in Ringo. We was up on upper stairs, and we would let her out to go to potty. Go do her business out there in the grass or something. And went after we gave her a good 15, 20 minutes out there. And then we'd open the door and call her. We called her Goldie. Because she was a golden color. Called her Goldie. And we'd call her name. She'd come trotting back up the stairs. Right back in the house. Well, one day we let her out to do that. And then when we went out to call her, she wouldn't come. We don't know what happened to her. She just up and disappeared. Well, don't know whether she went found somewhere in one of the woods around close by, found a place to die, or somebody else took her in, or she got out there and got run over somewhere, or somebody picked her up and took off with her, because she didn't have a collar. We didn't have a collar on her, because she stayed so close to us, we didn't worry. But I miss those animals very much. But let me know in the comments, you have a beloved animal friend, and if you've lost it. So though Solomon accept his treatment, often bursting out in song with praise to God, some days are harder. On one of those difficult days, Solomon hugged his mom and said, "I'm happy there's no shames in heaven." The degenerating effects of sickness affect all people on this side of eternity. So like Solomon, however, we have an enduring hope that can strengthen our resolve on those inevitable tough days. God gives us the promise of a new heaven and a new earth, Revelation 21, verse 1. Our Creator and Sustainer will dwell among us by making His home with us, verse 3. And He will wipe every tear from our eyes. There will be no more death, nor mourning, or crying, nor pain. Verse 4. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death. No more. Basically, the mourning is also called sorrow. It's another word for that is sorrow. No more sorrow, nor crying, nor pain. And that's part of a song that's called Alpha and Omega from the Gator Vocal Band. No more crying again. And praises to the great I am. We shall live in the light. Wait a minute. That's No More Night. That's the song I'm talking about. No More Night. Talking about no more tears. No more crying again. But it's also in Alpha and Omega. Because it comes out of that Revelation 21. So when the weight feels too hard or too long, we can experience peace because God's promise will be fulfilled. Amen? So how has acknowledging God's promise for a new heaven and a new earth comforted you? And how can you encourage a hurting friend with the enduring hope of God's promises? Let me know in the comments. Remember by Q1 or Q2. Ponder those questions by saying this phrase, which should be on the bottom of the screen. Make sure your subtitles are on so you can see them. And if you don't see them, check the description. But say, loving God, thank you for strengthening my resolve with the surety of my enduring hope. And for further study, read Prophetic Priorities, Wrestling with the End Times at discoveryseries.org. There's no slash number thing. It's just discoveryseries.org. And you'll probably look for it on there and you'll find it. Your Bible reading today is Ezekiel 24, 25, and 26, and in 1 Peter chapter 2. So, coming up tomorrow in your part 2, your only other video tomorrow, part 2, for Saturday, November 26, 2022, episode 913, part 2, we're going to be talking about blessed repentance from Arthur Jackson, derived from Hosea 14, verses 1 through 4. And then also, and that one will be tomorrow at, I'll try to put it probably about 3 o'clock, 2:45, 3, I'll probably put about 3:30. Wait a minute, no. Let's do it 2:45. Let's make it 2:45. Between 2:45 and 3 o'clock. So, at 7, 8 o'clock, you can have your bonus video for Monday's video number 127 of the Duh series that we missed on Monday because I was down with this facial swelling. Yeah, video 127 of the Dust series, when we talked about the names of men. From, we were supposed to do it Monday, but I have it recorded, and it will be posted Saturday evening, 7 or 8, 7, 8-ish. Sometime, just to give you a Saturday bonus video. And then the Tuesday one was supposed to be the 5th installment of the R's, the new R's series that I started, or the little mini series that I started. Hopefully there's some more in the new book, but if not, that'll be the last one. But that'll be next week on the 3rd, next Saturday. I chose to go ahead and record those because those were parts of some of my playlist. They were parts of series and playlists. I wanted to get them involved, but the rest of them I had pushed to the side and don't have to do them. But stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that later after, or you'll see that tomorrow at 2:45. I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. He'll keep you safe and all you say and do. 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back later after 7 and we'll be talking about episode 404 for the Turning Point series for your beautiful, fabulous Friday, November 25th, and we're going to be talking about medicine for the soul. Psalm 100 verse 4 is our main passage, but we'll be reading the whole Psalm 100 in the recommended reading. Our turning point is from Johnson Oatman, O-A-T-M-A-N, and our Bible reading is Romans 4, 5, 6, and 7. Those must be some short chapters, so. But stay tuned for that. I'll get that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that later after 7, hopefully. So, with that said, God bless everyone, and I'll see y'all later. Have a great rest of your afternoon, everybody, and I'll see you later tonight. Goodbye.